What's up, y'all? It's another new series I got popping, man. It's called Real MCs. And this episode is featuring the notorious heavyweight boxer from New York City, Mitch Green. Okay, this is Mike Tyson's probably biggest former heavyweight champion, Mike Tyson's greatest nemesis. All right, and this series is basically going to be about guys that I feel that have cold mouthpieces in the game. Give you some examples, you know, great talkers, great guys that can get on the mic and entertain. And this term MCs, rappers have taken it on and claimed it for themselves, but master of ceremony doesn't necessarily mean you're doing music. You could be hosting an event, telling jokes, whatever the case may be. Right, and the word rap from rap music actually applied to guys in the hood or the ghetto that had, you know, the spectacular vernacular. They had the ability to disarm people with their charm, you know, charm their way into females. You know, that's where the word rap came from. They said it was brother had a good rap. You know, hey, did you rap to Tanya yesterday, man? Meaning, did he kick it to Tanya? Did he try to get with Tanya yesterday? So, anyway, I'm just going to play a little bit of it. Let you hear the almighty Mitch Green.
Ring again. I don't know. I called him at a hobo. That don't work. I got a letter. See, I went at this two fights. The first fight I had with him, Don can't be my defense. He took my money. He got a gift, okay? After the street fight, he broke his hand on me. He had a catcher to his elbow. He ran. I got a letter saying he's supposed to fight me. Signed, sealed, delivered by Clayton. Now he was Don King trying to weasel out of the fight. Now I heard him with my suit for damages. Now I've got to force the Tootie Fruity to fight me. I call him a homo. That don't work.
He's talking about then current heavyweight champion of the world from Brownsville, Brooklyn. I am Mike Tyson.
Read my list. I'm saying it nice and slow. Michelle Cicely Tyson is a homo. He tooty fruity. I'm going to kick his blue jay.
Yo, he said Mike Tyson is tootie fruity and he gonna kick his booty. Tell me this guy is not a wrestling, a walking wrestling promo. This guy should have been in the WWE, man, or WCW or something like that, man. He shouldn't have been no boxer, man. He should have been a professional wrestler.
Hey, man, ask me a question, I tell you no lie. Mike Tyson is a homo in disguise. Don't spend your money. He gonna fight Frank, he fought Frank Bruno, Frank Scoopo. That was easy, Frank. Come on, now he's fighting Carl Trooper, Carl Fairytale, Will Carl. It's gonna be another easy payday. You know, and I'm going to win right now, never knocked out. Who left the fight? He broke his hand on me, he scared of me, he ducked me. I want Sasha's nose. Holy.
He's talking about the infamous street fight between him and then champion Iron Mike Tyson. They first fought to a 12-round decision, which Mike Tyson won that fight fairly easily, but he didn't hurt Mitch Green in the fight. And this was a time when Mike was knocking everybody out, beating the hell out of everybody. And Mitch Green danced around, and, you know, he didn't get really hurt in that fight, but he didn't hurt Mike either. Anyway, fast forward shortly after that, they run into each other in the famed Dapper Dan establishment in Harlem, the great clothing tailor, Dapper Dan. He walked into Dapper Dan and ran up on Mike Tyson, and they had a street fight. It's world famous. You can look into it. So he's talking about Mike Tyson breaking his hand in that particular street fight. This interview was actually done after the street fight, which happened after the 12-round fight.
Field. This is Holyfield. I'm gonna make a meal out of Holyfield and farm it. You want me to go to jail? Do the homicide. Damages, I'm saying. And he threatened He wanted to beat, Magic Johnson. And everything. What you gonna do when I take your woman out? I'm making a date with Robin Gibbons, baby. Now what you gonna do? Get mad at me, Tyson? The homo, Tutti Frutti, my pet peeve. Yes, dear. Son of man, kiss.
Yo. Mike Tyson, even himself, in a few different interviews, talked about running up on Brad Pitt in his house with Robin Givens. So I think Robin Givens was getting around. Now, he's talking about Robin Givens going out with Magic Johnson at the time, and Mike Tyson supposedly, in some rumor, getting that Magic Johnson. Mitch Green's a character. Check him out.
No man in the mouth. I got no tape. He kissed me in the mouth. He's a homo. He let me call him a homo. He ain't gonna deny it because he's scared of me. He broke his hand on me. His bad hand, and he put a capsule to his elbow. The next time me and Tyson fight, I'm gonna even let him in the car wreck. I'm gonna give him a whiplash and put a cast in that big old ugly neck. Ow! I'm gonna tell you another thing. I only had one of the biggest fights called Dylan Manila. My fight will be a little bit bigger. It'll be like King Kong versus Godzilla. Or if you wanna see a fight, I'll just have a treat. I'm gonna call it the Battle of the Beauty and the Beast. Because the ugly, dark, King ugly. I want you in South Algeria. South Algeria? Who is he? He's a trainer. You know what he told me? He said South Algeria used to train Cat Davis and woman, right? She knocked him out. He gonna train me. Oh, baby. He got knocked out. Did it that boy. He did it that boy. Tried to throw a fight up out there. For $10, I tried to beat him on my money. I put up the fight because he tried to beat my money. And he got made the best fight for $3,500. He gonna tell Mitch Green, Mitch Blood Green, I got $10 on a fight. This rap while you crazy. Bill DeRonimo packed a rubber check to Palula, gave me a rubber check. I got a check I play basketball with. I put up the fight.
Real quick, this wasn't no act. This was really this dude for real. I think Tyson even did a Broadway play, you know, a one-man show about his life, and he came out and did a comical imitation of Mitch Green, man. One of my brothers, man, closest friends in the world, we was just talking about a story where Mitch Green's family lived in his building. And he was in his building one day getting on the elevator, and Mitch Green was on the elevator. And going down to, I think, what, from the 10th floor down to the lobby, Mitch Green is going on a rant about how Mike Tyson ran from him. He's a sissy. He's a punk. He don't want to fight. I mean, this guy, this was who he was.
Give me rubber chick, Mitch Rumble. I got a manager to take a bus to work. He gonna talk about you. I'm manager. I'm great. Now I'm gonna show you something. Feast your eyes on a real heavyweight. Remember, I seen you live.
Here we go, WWF, baby.
Look like a man that messed with drugs. Look like a man that's capable of having a title fight. But give me good. Yeah. I saw my name, Miss Blood Green, that ain't no joke. My type used to drink purple, and I still drink coke. Yeah, and I love all y'all. Yeah. Come on, only in America.
I mean, this guy, I could go on and on with this video. This video hit particularly is damn near 15 minutes long, but I'll spare y'all some of that, right? And I'm gonna tell you who, there's actually a movie character, you know, that this guy, he could have been a splitting image of. And I think some of y'all know where I'm going with this. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, here it is.
Bow down to your master. Yeah, coolie. Now, when I say, who's the master? You say, show no.
That's Mike Tyson right there. Time out. Mike Tyson could have played in this movie.
Yeah, come on,
Leroy. Come on, Iron Mike.
Yeah, that's right. Bow, sucker.
Yeah.
Bow down to your master. Pooty, kiss my Converse.
So sorry. Excuse me.
Here come Mitch Green.
Am I the meanest?
Sure
enough. Am I the prettiest?
Sure enough.
Am I the baddest mofo down around this town?
Sure enough.
But who am I?
Sure enough.
Who am I?
Sure enough.
I can't hear you.
Mitch Blood Green.
Shoka.
So yeah, guys, I'm gonna wrap this up right now, man. First installment of Real MCs, man. Guys that just make me laugh. Guys that got crazy mouthpieces, you know. They this guy, he missed the social media era. You know, he missed YouTube, he missed Facebook, Instagram. This guy would have been a huge star if he would have chose professional wrestling as his career. All right, I'll catch y'all on the next Real MCs.